Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, Lesson Number 17. The topic it is Trigonometry Ratio 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson course. Today we are going to get the simple trigonometric graphs. Drawing the graphs and using them to solve getting the trigonometric ratios. We have the first example. Draw the graph of y is equal to sine theta for the values of 0 degrees raised or equal to x, which is between 360. So it is between 0 to 360. Solution. So you are supposed to first of all get the values of x. Remember the interval is 30, so it's supposed to be 0, 30 degrees, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180, 210, 240, 270, 300, 330, and 360. From there now, you just get the sine of 0, sine of 30, sine of 60 until you get to the 360. As you can be able to see, the values are there. We have 0. It is supposed to be 0. 30, it's supposed to be 0.5. 60, it's supposed to be 0.8660. 90, it's supposed to be 0.5. 120, it's supposed to be 0. 150, it's supposed to be negative 0.5. 180, it is supposed to be 0. 210, it is supposed to be negative 0.5. 240, it's supposed to be 0.8660, negative. 270 is supposed to be negative 1. 300 is supposed to be negative 0.8660. And then 330 is supposed to be negative 0.85. And 360 is supposed to be 0. From there, we plot the values, then we join them. This is the way it's supposed to be. You can see we have plotted the values and then joined the lines. That is the kind of the graph. It's supposed to be marked. Y is equal to the sine theta. Use the graph above to find the sine x is equal to 0.71. So what do we do? We just come to the graph. Just go to where 0.71 is, which is around here, almost here. And then you come to the graph, then you go down, read the values. You just go down and then you read the value. Then you go to the sine x is equal to 0.60. You still come back to the graph, go to where 0.6 is, then go to the graph, then go down, read that value. So that is the way you are supposed to read them. Even if it was negative, you are supposed to come, get the negative value where it is, then from there go straight to where the graph, then downwards to the where it is. So in that case now, that is how we use the graphs to get the trigonometric ratios. For example, have been told to find the trigonometric ratios of 45 degrees, which can be seen it is here. So I'll just come and then go to where the graph is. Then I read the ratio, which is supposed to be there. So that is how we use the graph to solve the equation. We go to the next one. This is the kind of the graph that we have. For y is equal to the sine x, you can also have that one. But this one now, that is just an example of how we get it. Let us take another example. Draw the graph of y is equal to the cos x for the values of 0 degrees to the 2 pi radians. 2 pi. Solution, I'm supposed to draw the table. Then from there, plot them and then draw the graph. As you can be able to see, I have the angles from zero all the way to the 2 pi radians. So in that case, we have the values there. We have 0 is 1, pi 6 divided by 6 radian, which is 0.8660. We have the values there. Then we plot them and get that kind of a graph. Then we can also use that graph to find, the values of, course, x is equal to 0.3. So what do we do? We just come back here using the y-axis. We get 0.3 where it is. Remember the graph book we should have, they are demarcated. So you just come there, then read the value. Which angle is that? The same case, a point where we have cos x is equal to 0.99. You just go back to the graph. Go to where 0.9 is. You just go to where 0.9 is. Just cut across, get to the graph, then downwards, get where that angle is, and then you read it. The assignment for today, draw the graph of y is equal to tan x for 0 degrees all the way to 360 using the intervals of 30 degrees. Then use that graph to get tan x, which is equal to negative tan x negative 1.2. tan x is equal to 0.7 and tan x is equal to negative 0.2. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, that edition. You can contact us through the SMSing. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to EdimTV. Thank you.